evening, everyone. Welcome to the Audit and Risk Management reconvene meeting from I think it was June. Before we start, can I just ask the name the contact officer on the top of our agenda is Mark Delatt. Sadly, Mark passed away a week or so ago, and I'd just like the committee to stand and have a minute's silence. Item one on the agenda is the members' code of conduct and declaration of interest. Do we have any declarations? The matter being considered tonight is important. It's been ongoing since June 2011. There have been a lot of allegations made and issues and concerns raised since 2011. A number of important steps have been taken and the committee has received a considerable volume of papers to consider and to digest. Papers have been redacted to protect businesses and companies against whom the allegations and concerns are not made or directed. The names of officers and other individuals have also been redacted as appropriate. And it's important that the committee recognises the need to ensure that names of businesses and companies and commercial sensitive information are protected and that appropriate steps are taken to protect identities. I accept that the committee must satisfy itself of whether whatever line of inquiry it considers necessary to reach an informed decision, but that cannot be at the expense of exposing the council to a risk of legal challenge and potential liability. I would therefore remind everyone, including anyone addressing the committee, not to name businesses, companies, individuals or officers of the council. Any issues involving officers should be addressed to the council as officers act on behalf of the council. Is that okay with everyone? Sure.
That's fine, as far as it goes to my point. I did want to just ask a question on the subject of the redaction, so I'm clear. You read out what was redacted, and that list is, I suppose, the big resources concerns on page 461, and ISUS is on 470, officers' names, enterprise solution names, financial information, and contacts within the appendixes. However, when one looks through some of the documentation, one can see that the length of some of the redactions striking and possibly having redacted more than what would appear to me to be a small amount of information. I know one of the redactions in particular was challenged over the summer. That was on page 52, and the new papers that we received, the redaction has been taken from the whole paragraph J on page 52 to just a very small line there. But there are other redactions that were made on page 58 and page 73 where entire paragraphs are still redacted. I just wanted some assurance with you that, you know, for example, page 58, four lines are redacted. Well, set a list of names, except we'll see our four lines would fit in with the criteria for reduction. And on page 73, the ISUS executive summary, seven lines are redacted. And having now seen the one that's challenged, it's clear that paragraph J in the report to Peter Simmons didn't meet the criteria that we've been told paragraphs are redacted for. So, just a concern to put on the table. I don't know why, where we go with it, particularly what I say to the legal officer, to give us assurance that, that the redactions that I've mentioned and others that the paper do indeed meet the criteria of our guiding. I think anything else that really has been brought to my attention.
Thank you, Ashley.
Thank you, Chair. In essence, it's a judgment that we have to exercise in terms of the level of redaction, and we try to keep any level of redaction to the minimum required. Sensitive information, and some one of the tests that we do have to apply is whether or not, through a reasonable inquiry, an individual will be able to piece together essentially the information. And so sometimes a narrative has to be redacted, because without, by not doing so, it would be possible to work out exactly the individual or the name or the personal information or commercially sensitive information to protect. And so I take the point. I think in some cases, unfortunately, it is necessary to do that, because there's a lot of information that has been provided. And one of the issues that we have in mind from as an organisation is that if we know there's information already in the public domain which could be utilised in order to fill in the gaps and work out exactly what has been redacted, then that potentially still needs to be exposed.
Okay, then let's move on to item two, and if I can ask Mr. Hobro if he could come up. This is 15 minutes.
I'll get myself a glass of water by then. It's been a long road, and in fact, if I may quote Shakespeare, this appears to be a plot of land that we fought over, not worthy of the name. That's from Hamlet. And there have been many protestations.